tell us about your article in the magazine. What is the main conclusion that it comes to?
These companies, especially Upside Foods, promised that they would deliver a center of plate sort of style of meat that is an equal substitute to folks who enjoy eating meat, different from the plant-based industry where, you know, it's not necessarily one-to-one and it's not necessarily real meat. There are other components, vegetables and other things like that mixed in. And what has become clear is over the years, after hundreds of millions of dollars in funding for Upside Foods in particular, the company is still struggling to make the technology work to actually deliver what it has promised over the years.
Well, like the basics, though, is it even revenue generating? In other words, does it have a meat product, lab grown, that it sells anywhere?
Right now, the company is supplying small amounts to a restaurant, very, very, very small amounts, and it's far away from being able to make a similar product at scale for supermarkets. And for years, the promise has been that these kinds of companies will, by 2021, enter supermarkets like Costco. And the idea was, people love eating meat. Why should we slaughter more animals for it?
What ultimately has been perhaps an exuberance about the timetable here. Is there any reality that we'll start to see lab-grown meat on our plates more quickly? Because you have this beautiful part of the story where you're saying that basically people are having to sort of dig out of test tubes and make one very small, tiny piece of chicken at the moment,
right,
when they should be making much larger amounts, it would feel.
That's right. There are a number of companies in this space that say they're going to use animal cells to create sort of hybrid products that are partly plant-based, partly this lab-grown meat, to make a plant-based meatball taste more like actual chicken or actual beef, for example. And these companies say that they will, in a couple of years, have these sort of hybrid products available. But at the same time, the process has been slow moving, and many of the largest companies are still only in these small scale tasting events. And in the case of Upside Foods, we've learned that the company has yet to actually be producing at scale.